Hello, so welcome to another video. Unfortunately, it's not the video you want. Although you can possibly convince me otherwise on this. You guys deserve an explanation of why there's not been another ESP video for a while, and what the future holds as well. You can probably guess by the tone of my voice, and what this is about. I don't want to dwell on the reasoning too much, but given how much support you guys have given those videos and the love and the comments, I think I at least owe you an explanation. It's possibly not too surprising given I'm mirrored that down there. I've Ukrainian heritage. My grandfather's from Ukraine. My mother's maiden name is very Ukrainian. Not going to share that, don't worry. And I have friends over there in the east, very east. And it's pretty shocking, to be honest. That alone has taken a big mental toll on me. Very difficult to deal with what's going on over there. Hopefully, you're in a country where you can get access to proper media, impartial media, and you can do your own research to see what's wrong and what is right in terms of what's being published. If you're not, I think they're doing quite a good job of locking down videos like this, but yeah, you can find it. China, of course, are a supporter of Russia and being very open about it. Very open about it. Espressif have got nothing to do with this, except for the fact that they are based in China. And that supports the Chinese economy, which is supporting Russia, which is supporting genocide. Promoting anything that comes out of China or is anything to do with China, morally, I find impossible to do. And it sucks. Really, really sucks. For a lot of people, obviously, you're going to miss out on some, hopefully, what would have been nice content and content that you're enjoying. Missing out on me being able to support a company, Espressif, and a product that genuinely, and you know the way I've spoken about the ESP32 in the past, it is excellent, absolutely superb, and the IDF is chef's kiss compared to anything else out there. That maintains the quality of their stuff. His has not decreased, in fact, it's actually got better. But morally, I can't publicly support it at the moment unless China changes the stance. I just can't do it. I'm waffling now. I'm trying to think of the right words to say. I don't want this to be political, I want it to be moral. And I'm not trying to influence anyone else on this. I still have my ESPs here. I still use the ones I've got. No, I'm not going to buy any more, because that would be pretty hypocritical. And also, I've got millions of the things anyway. And they're great. I just can't be a public face for it. As impartial as I am and as British as I am, and nothing to do with anything that's going on politically. Nor do I have any political sway to change the minds. Hopefully, in the future, if the minds do change and things progress towards peace and some sort of resolution that is fair, then maybe we can pick this up again. The only other way of this continuing would be from suggestion in the comments down below and I don't even know what you could say, to be honest. But I never say never. There's always something I've not thought of. There's always something that might just ignite that little spark that just pushes me over that moral edge to say, actually, no, it is fine to continue doing the videos and the teaching and the education. I miss it. I do really, really miss it. And interestingly, just as an aside, I was made redundant today, this morning. It's now, what, 4:30 in the afternoon. So I'm now on the job hunt again. Whether I find something working on ESP32s again, I don't know. I highly doubt it. I think I was pretty lucky to find the job that I got. If you remember when I started that, how excited I was. This came completely out of the blue, the dissolving the entire UK company, so it's not just me. It's, yeah, real shame. I've put on my CV, so I've had three recruiters now phone me this morning, and I should probably show you this because it is a bit of a laugh, and I don't want this to all be tears and crying and so on. If I can find it, I just want to read you the line, the first line on my CV. Here we go. The biggest vision I have, so this is at the top of my CV. You got my name, my address. No, I'm not showing on the screen. Nice try. My LinkedIn and my GitHub. And then you've got this line. The biggest vision I have is to bring the vast benefits of modern C++ to the embedded world, which is often decades behind. Now, that is a really pointed statement. And the three recruiters I've spoken to so far today, bearing in mind I only put this CV out at about 11:30 this morning, have said, that's a bit of a spicy statement, Simon. There's going to be a lot of companies that don't like you for that because they are old dinosaurs. I said, yep, that's the point. Because I don't want to work for a company full of old dinosaurs unless they are up for the discussion of how we can make things better in the embedded world. That does not come with the caveat of, and you must do it. That would be nice, if I can convince them enough. But being up for the discussion of looking at how we can make the embedded world better without being stuck on C99, which is fine, nothing wrong with C, not C bashing here, but C++ is better in a lot of ways, pretty much every way, to be perfectly honest. If you look at this objectively, all the arguments for, but it does depend what you do. You pick the right language for the job, clearly, but most of the time for the stuff that you've seen on this channel and the things that we've talked about, C++ offers more than what C can offer. Compile time stuff is just an insta win, you know. So anyway, I thought that would be a funny thing to end it on. I am sorry, I am deeply sorry. Clearly this is what's happening, and what's caused this is nothing to do with me or any of you guys, and no one could have seen it having the moral impact in my head, along with the anxiety and the depression that goes with it, that would cause me to have this dilemma. As I say, feel free down below in the comments if you think you've got a way to make me see it a different way. Please try. I can't promise that it'll work. But if I can leave you with that thought of, at least you tried, rather than sitting there wondering, well, what could have been? Or if you've got a completely different idea, let's look at STM32s, for example, or an NRF chip or a microchip, Texas Instruments, something like that, whatever Or if there's something you want to do at the desktop level, anything. You know what my skill sets are, and you know what I'm good at and what I can turn my hand to. And I want to teach you guys what I know. Might not be the right way, probably won't be the wrong way, but we can learn together and all get better. In the meantime, for content, if you're looking for C++ stuff, stay up to date with C++ Con, CPP Con on YouTube, where they put the conferences. Really good for the cutting edge stuff. For embedded, yes, you do have to sort of figure out how we can make this applicable to embedded, because a lot of it needs a bit more careful thought, particularly along the containers such as standard vector, and so on, and standard string that can allocate in quite spicy ways. Small stuff, as long as you can work around it and you can guarantee it and so on, you can wrap those vectors to make sure they don't go above certain sizes and so on. That's pretty much a fine way of doing it with a little bit of cost associated to it. But you can work that out, and feel free, like, if for whatever reason this channel doesn't, nothing happens in the future. I desperately hope that's not the case. I don't see why it would be the case. But if you're watching something and you're not getting the answers, or you can't figure it out, and you don't want to ask in their comments, or you don't want to ask on Reddit, CPP Questions is quite a good subreddit for stuff like that. But just put them down in the comments here. As I say, that's not a plea for me to get more interactions on YouTube. I'm not big enough to get monetized, nor do I particularly want to be. And even if I did, you wouldn't make enough money to be able to claim it. You have to earn a certain amount of money before you can actually withdraw that from YouTube. That's never going to happen. And nor do I want to be under any YouTube contract, to be honest. So it's free content as far as I'm concerned. So yeah, that's the discussion. As I say, anything down below, I'm more than happy to do little just chatting videos like this. So if you have a specific question where, it turns out it's going to be hard for me to answer that in the comments, then I'll make a video. I can always do it, pretty much always do it, non-ESP related. So I can pull up Visual Studio Code and we can do something in the Windows environment, because most of it can be abstracted out to the higher level. So there will be no reference to Espressif or anything like that. As I say, things in the future will change. I'm sure they will. I hope it won't drag on for years, like the predictions are saying. But yeah, we can figure something out between us. If you guys have got the appetite for videos, then please help me find a way to do it. So that's me. Health-wise, gosh. I don't know if it comes across on camera. I'm doing so much better, as might know from a video I did a couple of years ago. I had an operation. I had a tumor on the pituitary gland at the base of my brain. Huge depression, anxiety, and everything that went with it, with all my hormones, well, not existing, literally. So yeah, I've really perked up this year. And I'm not smoking either. I got off the vape, pretty much off drink as well. Not that that was ever out of control per se, but yeah, I just feel so much better for it. And I must say, I know it sounds really cheesy, but every now and then, when a comment pops up on my, a notification pops up on my phone that one of you guys has commented on a video and said thank you, or had a question or a suggestion, or even just saying, "Nah, this is a bunch of shit, Si, what are you on about?" It puts a smile on my face every time. You have no idea the impacts that has on little old me's life. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you very, very much. Yeah, that's it. This video has gone on far too long. Thank you. Hopefully see you on the next one.